Okay, so your Windows experience is about to change. Get ready to discover something not many people know about. It's a set of free utilities by Microsoft that will give you more control over your device. And you get more control by helping you troubleshoot, diagnose, manage, and monitor your Windows device. It's called SysInternals. It sounds like something bad you might hear after a medical checkup, but it's a great thing. It's actually not new. It's been around since 1996. Computers did look different back then. So did I. SysInternals was later acquired by Microsoft and is still being maintained, and new features are being constantly added. But before we dive into the depths of SysInternals, make sure to hit that subscribe button so you never miss out on cool new content that I have in store for you. First, let's check how you can get these tools. Visit the SysInternals Utilities Index page. There you can either download each tool separately, there are like over 70 to choose from. You're gonna see a short description of each tool's function. Or you can download the full SysInternals suite, which is what I'm gonna do. It's gonna download a zip file of around 45 megabytes. In the Downloads folder, just right-click on the zip file and select Extract All. Then configure a destination folder of your choice and click the Extract button. SysInternals tools are portable and they don't require any installation. You can just start them from the folder that you just created. Just be aware that some of the tools require admin access to function properly, so be sure to right-click on the tool and select Run as Administrator. The first utility we're going to look at is called ZoomIt. Trust me, this is one of those things that once you start using it, you wonder how you've even survived before it came along. In the suite, you're going to find a 32-bit and a 64-bit version. Just double-click the executable to start it. The first time you run ZoomIt, it presents a configuration dialog. You can select alternate shortcuts and customize some features, but let's see what this tool has to offer first. One thing you can do is to magnify a certain area on your screen. Use the default shortcut Ctrl+1 and it's going to immediately zoom in. Then use the mouse wheel to zoom even more in or back out. You can move around the screen as well. You can even annotate the screen to highlight important information while you're zoomed in. You can add freeform like this or add different shapes. Use Ctrl+Shift to add arrows. Add rectangles by holding down Ctrl, or ellipses with Tab. If you hold down Shift, you can draw straight lines. If you want to share your annotated screen, use the shortcut Ctrl+S to save it as a zoomed PNG, or just hit Ctrl+C to copy and paste it in any application you want. You can also annotate without zooming. Use the shortcut Ctrl+2 to enter drawing mode. You're going to see the tip of the pen here. You can change the size of the pen by holding Ctrl and turning the mouse wheel. You can also change the color of the pen by typing different keys, for example, G for green, R for red, P for pink, O for orange, and so on. If you need a fresh canvas, just hit K on your keyboard and start drawing. Or type W if you want a whiteboard. Now, if you have ugly handwriting like me, press T and type out the text. What's even better is that you can even record the whole session. Use the shortcut Ctrl+5 and you're going to see this border around the screen. Press Ctrl+5 again to stop the recording. Save the file as an MP4 and share it after the meeting. Another cool thing is that you can quickly set a break timer. This way your audience knows when they're expected to be back. You can customize it in the options. Open the tray and click on ZoomIt. Then select Options. In the tab Break, you can set the timer, and in the Advanced Settings, you can even add a custom image for the background. Then use Ctrl+3 to bring it up. This is an amazing tool, definitely worth checking out. The next tool we're going to look at is called Process Monitor. Process Monitor, or PROCMON, is one of the most powerful tools in SysInternals when it comes to troubleshooting. It does require admin rights, so to start it, right-click on the executable and select Run as Administrator. The moment you open the tool, it's going to start a real-time trace and capture events from 5 different classes: Registry, File System, Network, Processes, and Profiling Events. So here you can see every single event that's happening on my system. When you right-click and select Properties on an event, you can actually see the entire stack that led to this operation. These thousands of rows can be quite overwhelming, so the key here is to filter out as much as possible and only focus on the events that interest you. There are different ways to do that. For example, if you want to set focus on third-party apps, you can filter out all the Microsoft processes. Go to Options, select Columns, and check the box next to Company Name. This is going to add it as a column in the overview. Then right-click on any row in this column and select Exclude, and then Company. This way, it's going to filter out all events from Microsoft. Or let's say you want to find out which events change your registry values. You can set a filter by clicking on the filter icon up here. In the drop-down, we get different options. For example, you could filter for a specific application by selecting process name. But let's say we don't know the exact application yet, and we're interested in all operations that change our registry values. So we're going to select operations, and then over here, we can specify what we're looking for. Look at all these options. In our case, we're looking for registry changes. So I'm going to start by just typing reg, and here it is, reg set value. Then click on add, which is going to add the filter. Now, when we click on OK, it's going to apply the event filter, and we only see events that change registry values. Another cool thing you can do with Process Monitor is to create a boot log, because maybe your computer takes a very long time to boot, or you want to check for malware. To create such a log, just click on Options and select Enable Boot Logging. This brings up a new window. You get the option to generate thread profiling events and how often these profiling events are generated. In my case, I'm going to go with every second. Click on OK and close down the process monitor. Reboot your system now.
A few moments later.
And once it's back up, start process monitor again. Don't forget that step or else it's going to just keep monitoring and create a humongous file. When you start procmon, you're going to see this message pop up to save the collected data. Confirm it and select where you want to save the file.
Moments later.
In my case, it created this 3 GB log file. To narrow it down, let's set a filter. Click on the filter icon and select duration. For the operator, let's use more than. And let's start with anything that took more than 5 seconds. I'm just going to put in a 5 and click on add. Then OK, and it's going to apply this filter. And these are the processes that took that long. You can check them out in more detail to see if they're really needed or not. It's super cool, and these are just few use cases of procmon. It really is one of the most powerful tools out there. Next up is another handy feature called Autoruns. Autoruns is a utility that helps you identify software that's configured to run when you start your device. You're going to be surprised at how many processes are launched without you even knowing of them. After running Autorun, you're going to see this interface, which is made up of multiple tabs. The Everything tab is going to show you everything that's loaded automatically, and look at this list. But that's quite confusing, and that's why you have all these other tabs to help you narrow things down. The Logon tab shows you everything that's loaded when you log on to the system. Or in this tab, this is for when you launch Explorer. Or schedule tasks, services, drivers, and so on. To narrow things down even more, you can hide everything that's Microsoft related. To do that, click on Options in the menu. You'll see that Hide Windows Entries is already checked by default. So let's now hide all Microsoft entries. This way, we can really focus on what third-party apps have configured. So let's say you're not sure about this process here. You can submit it to VirusTotal to run it through up to 75 virus scanners. The first time you do this, you'll have to activate it and accept the terms. Once the file is submitted, you'll see the results in the VirusTotal column. This will give you a good indication if something is malicious or not. If you want to actually disable an auto start entry, all you have to do is to uncheck its checkbox. That's it. Another great tool, and much better than the standard task manager. The last utility we're going to look at is called Process Explorer. With Process Explorer, you get to see dynamic information about your running system. Think of it as a task manager on steroids. Run it as admin, and it's going to show you all processes that are currently active on the system in the main window. They're presented in a tree structure showing the parent-child relationships. But that's not all. If you activate the lower pane view, you get to also show the DLL handles and threads that are linked to a process. Let's go with DLL. So now if we click on system process, for example, we see in the lower pane all the DLLs and memory map files that system process loaded. You can also scan the image signatures for known viruses. VirusTotal is going to run these through up to 75 antivirus scanners. If you see 0 out of 75 like here, it means none of them found anything. One of its most common uses is to find out which process has a particular file open and prevents its use by another program. Let's say you want to delete this folder here, but when you try, you get this message. To find out which program is locking this file, go to Process Explorer, click on Find in the menu, and then select Find Handle or DLL. Then type in the name of the file or folder. In my case, it's Leila Test Folder. Then click on Search. It looks like in my case, the culprit is Camtasia and has a file in this folder open. There are many other use cases for Process Explorer. For example, you can prioritize a process, which can be interesting for some gamers, or you can pause or suspend a process if it's giving you trouble. It's another handy tool in the Sys Internal suite. Give it a try. Well, that was just a taste of what's included in Sys Internals. There's plenty more utilities that I didn't even get a chance to cover in this video. So grab yourself a copy, check it out for yourself. Now, before you leave, if you have a favorite utility, please let me know in the comments what it is. I'd love to know. That's it for today, and I'll catch you next time.